So, good morning, students. Yes, we are again with the chapter of this change in profit sharing ratio. I hope you all are fine. Myself, Mr. YOGESH DAGA. Today's date is the 4th May, that is the Monday. We are going to continue with this chapter of change in profit sharing ratio, which I have taken in the last class. Okay, the last topic, which is of today. After that, this chapter will be going to be over. From the next video, the new chapter, that is the admission of a partner, is going to be starting. Student, the topic which we today are going to take is based on adjustment of capital. Now, first of all, I would like to ask you, what do you mean by adjustment of capital? Student, this chapter, that is the change in profit sharing ratio, is based on the various topics, that is whether we are required to take an adjustment for the accumulated reserves, the revaluation of the assets and liabilities, the treatment related to the goodwill, the treatment related to any type of losses, and this topic, that is the adjustment of the capital. Now student, this chapter where the old ratio and the new ratio of the partners are given, in this we have calculated the sacrificing ratio and the gaining ratio in this chapter. Now students, once there is a change in profit sharing ratio, partners also decides to change their capital. Suppose A, B and C are the partners having a capital of rupees 50,000, 50,000 and 1 lakh. But due to the change in profit sharing ratio, now this partners decides to change their capital as 70,000, 70,000 and 80,000. Now student, from this you can see the earlier capital of 50-50 of the two partners, now they are required to change the capital as a 70-70. So they are required to bring 20,000 more from their house. And the one of the partners capital was rupees 1 lakh and he decides to change the capital into 80,000. So he is to be given back 20,000 because it was the extra money that was with him. So this one is the topic related to the adjustment of the capital, because in the change in profit sharing ratio, partners also decides to adjust their capital. So here we go. What is adjustment of capital? This capital rearrangement means the contribution of the partners towards capital are rearranged on the basis of new profit sharing ratio. Students, see, the capital is to be adjusted based on the new profit sharing ratio. For this purpose, the capital of the old partner must be adjusted with the goodwill revaluation account and past profit. Student, in this topic, earlier we have done the adjustment related to the profit sharing ratio, any type of reserves, any type of losses, revaluation of the assets. Okay? All these things is to be done first. After that, the capital of the partners is to be adjusted. So students, in this change in profit sharing ratio, first of all, we have done with the adjustment of accumulated reserves, profits and losses. After that, we have done with the adjustment of goodwill of the firm among the partners. Then we have done the revaluation of the assets and the liabilities. And the today's topic is adjustment of capital, which we are going to do today. Okay, now. So, I hope you got the point. Adjustment of capital means rearrangement of the capital. Okay, next. Capital adjustment can be done in the various steps. For that, first of all, you are required to know what is the total capital of the new firm is given. It is given in the question. So, you must know what is the capital which is given. The new ratio is also given in your question. The new ratio is also provided. So based on these two things, you are required to find out the new capital. The new capital is equal to total capital into the partner's share. Okay, this one is the new capital. Now, like the earlier example which we have seen, the earlier capital was 50 and now the capital becomes 70. So if the new capital is more than the earlier capital, then it is the surplus capital to be brought by the partner in case. As we have said already, the capital or capital was rupees 50, the new capital was of rupees 70. So 20,000 is the new capital that they are required to put from their house. If the new capital is less than the earlier capital, that is of the partner C, whose earlier capital was rupees 1 lakh and the new capital becomes 80,000. So this was the extra 20,000 was there with the firm. So firm is required to give him back that extra 20,000. So based on this, today we are going to do this one question. Okay, I hope you will like this question. Following is the balance sheet of A and B, who shared profit and loss in the ratio of 2:1 on the 1st April. The balance sheet also provided. On the above day, the partners changed their profit sharing ratio to 3:2. The old ratio was 2:1. The new ratio becomes 3:2. For this purpose, the goodwill of the firm was valued at 3 lakhs. So goodwill of the firm is 3 lakhs. The partners also agreed the following. The value of land and buildings should be 5 lakhs. The reserve is to be maintained at rupees 3 lakh. The total capital of the partners in the new firm will be rupees 6 lakh, which is to be shared. Student, in the earlier slide, I have already said you, in your question, the total capital of the new firm will be given. The new ratio also will be given. And here, the topic of the value of land and building, it means revaluation is also provided. A reserve is to be maintained. That is the topic of accumulated reserve also. So from this, you are required to take the screenshot of this question. So in the next slide, we are going to go with the answers only. So this was the question. Now, answer based on the above adjustment of capital. Student, I have said you, every time first we are required to go with the working note, then we can go with the answer. So in the working of note, that I have already said the new capital is given, that is of rupees 6 lakh. And the new ratio is also provided, that is the 3:2. So first of all, we will find with the new capital of A and B, that is 6 lakh into 3/5, it becomes 3 lakh 60. And the bill, that is 6 lakh into 2/5, it becomes 2 lakh 40. Now student, in the question, new ratio is also provided and old ratio is also given. So we are required to do that one working note also. We are required to find out the sacrificing ratio. So that based on this, sacrificing ratio is old ratio minus the new ratio. So from this old ratio, A, that is equals to 1/5. And in bracket, it is given sacrificing. And the B, who is having a minus, that is negative 1/15. That is he is gaining. So A is gaining, A is sacrificing by 1/15. Whereas B is gaining by 1/15. So based on this, our entry is always the sacrificing partner is to be given a credit, whereas the partner who is gaining is given to the debit. Okay, so goodwill was of rupees 3 lakh. Student, I have already said you, in the earlier slides, we have also taken that the goodwill is always distributed in the sacrificing ratio in this chapter. So based on that, A sacrifice, that is 3 lakh into 1/15, that is equals to 20,000. And the B gain, that is 3 lakh into 1/15, that is equals to 20,000. So our entry becomes B's capital account debit to A's capital. So student, this entry is to be given effect in the balance sheet, that is the partner's capital. Now we are here, we go with the next slide. So student, this one is the revaluation account, partner's capital account and the balance sheet. Student, the first adjustment was related to the revaluation of the land and building. Okay, so land and building, which are to be increased. So increase in the land and building is our profit, and this is to be written on the credit side of the revaluation account, which we have done in the our earlier slides related to the revaluation account. Okay, so land and building, which is increased by 2 lakh 50, and earlier the value was rupees 2 lakh 90. So based on that, now new value of the land and building, which is our 5 lakh. Okay. Next, the second adjustment was related to the reserves. In that, it was given that reserves is to be taken, to be maintained at rupees 3 lakh. Okay, now student, in our question, already the reserves are given of rupees 1 lakh 50 and the new reserve is to be maintained of rupees 3 lakh. So that 1 lakh 50 which is given in our balance sheet is to be distributed to the partners in their old ratio. Old ratio, so it is given that reserves on the credit side of the partner's capital account as 1 lakh and 50,000. Okay, and the new reserve is to be maintained at 3 lakh. So that 3 lakh is to be given effect based on the new ratio, which we have already given that reserves, the second adjustment, 3 lakh is to be distributed in 3:2, that is 1 lakh 80 and 1 lakh 20, and this reserve will come in our balance sheet, that is given by the number 2, that is 3 lakh. Okay, so student, based on this, you can see that old reserve is to be distributed to the partners in the old ratio always, and the new reserve is to be distributed in the new ratio, and that reserve is to be taken in the balance sheet. Student, we can give the net effect also. Okay, so based on that, if the net effect earlier was 1,50,000 and the new reserve is of rupees 3 lakh, so only difference 1,50,000 is to be given in the sacrificing to gaining ratio. Okay, student, we can take that also. Next, the adjustment is related to the goodwill is also given. Student, you can see the goodwill, which is the entry which was there, B's capital account debit to A's capital account. So in the B, in A account, B's capital, that is 20,000, and in A capital, that is A's capital, in B it is given 20,000. We have given the entry related to debt, which we have done in the earlier slide. And the third adjustment was related to the capital. Student, I have already said you, the capital is to be distributed in the new ratio, which we have taken the working note number 1. 6 lakh was distributed in the 3:2, which comes to 3,60,000 and 2,40,000. And this capital, that is balance sheet, is always taken to the balance sheet as A capital account, A 3,60,000 and B 2,40,000. So student, this was our adjustment. The remaining item, now what we have required to do, after all the adjustments are done, the revaluation profit is to be distributed to the partners in their old ratio. Okay, so revaluation profit we got is rupees 2,10,000. This is to be distributed in the old ratio, that is 2:1. Then here becomes A's capital, that is 1,40,000, and B's capital, that is 70,000. And this is given to the credit side of the partner's capital account, revaluation account, 1,40,000 and 70. Now student, we have taken the balance adjustment of the capital, that is 3,60,000 and 2,40,000. It is always given after the effect of revaluation reserves are given. So in this question, we have taken the balance brought down of the partner's reserves, B's capital, that is goodwill distribution, revaluation account, and here also the reserves, which are the new reserves to be maintained. After all, we have taken the new capital, that is 3,60,000 and 2,40,000. So based on this, you will find the difference in the partner's capital account, that is in the A's account also, and also as a result on the B's capital account also. So here, the A's capital difference is of rupees 20,000. That is the difference amount is to be given to the partner because he is having an extra capital. Whereas the B is having a difference of 60,000, it means his capital are less and he is required to maintain more capital. So he will bring 60,000. So remaining item that is there in the balance sheet is to be put as it is. We are not required to change that things. Only the change is there in the cash, which is all earlier value was 30,000. 60,000 to be brought by B, and 20,000 is to be given back to the A, which is given in our question. We have found it out. Okay, so cash will be 70,000, and based on this, our balance sheet will tell you. Student, this was the last topic of our chapter, the change in profit-sharing ratio. If you are having any doubt related to this topic, you are free to contact me via video call or conference, or if you want, then any other medium can be used. Okay, student, you know my number. My number is 9879373401, and my email ID yogeshdaga2017@gmail.com. Okay, student, I hope you got all the points. Thank you.